there, welcome. Today I wanted to play with a fun pose that looks way harder than it actually is. It's one of those crazy poses that everyone ogles at and thinks, oh my god, how could you possibly do that? But actually, once you figure out a few of the tips and tricks with it, it becomes pretty doable, actually. The trick is not to psych yourself out, right? So don't get freaked out about it. But take it step by step and try to really move through it logically. We're going to do eight limbs pose, Ashtavakrasana, a really fun, crazy looking pose. I'm here in Austin, it's really nice out, so let's get started. Okay, super simple. The way I like to come into this easiest for me is, so I thread one hand, so I'm going to take my right hand through my legs. Now notice I got my ankles crossed. Ankles are crossed and feet are gently flexing. So I thread one hand through, the right arm through the legs. I'm going to set up my foundation. So checking out that my hands are going to be about shoulder distance apart. I'm going to slide those hands, fingers, knuckles, palms, a little gecko asana to get them set up and super strong and mindful in the fingertips. So you're going to really use strong hands, right? So I've got them out to the side, about a foot away from my hips. Now I'm going to shift myself so that the inner right thigh is going to come as high as I can on my upper right arm. So I'm going to just go ahead and hike the whole thing up. Keep the ankles crossed, so don't lose this connection here. Lift it up, bring that thigh up as high as you can on your upper arm, right? So it connects, it kind of glues to your upper arm. Then you begin to shift the weight by bending your elbows and lift and shifting your heart out over your hands, right? So I'm going to go this way. Now my heart keeps sliding out over the hands until I feel the weight begin to come into my wrists and fingertips. Then, so my feet are floating off the floor, I can feel a lot of weight on my inner thigh and the upper arm. That connection point is going to be my balancing point. Keep sliding until you feel that weight go, and then see if you can begin to even let your hips kind of shift off the earth, right? So shift the hips, lift your hips up a little bit. When you feel that balance, elbows bend, remember, so the trick here, what most people forget, is not to bend, they don't bend their elbows enough. So I get a lot of these kind of things. You have no leverage. You really have to leverage off that top arm. That is your shelf, right? So bending a lot, bring your heart down towards the floor so that you have the leverage. Then, once you feel that balance point and you can float your hips, this is where the ankles crossed becomes a thing, right? So you keep those feet actively flexing. They kind of hook around each other like cross fingers. And then just extend, push your legs out. So I've got this balance, I've got my ankles crossed, and then I'm gonna begin to push, squeezing my thighs together as I push my legs out long and squeeze them out there as far as I can go. So keep my feet flexing, that's gonna keep that power extending and lengthening out. And then you can even lift your heart up a little bit and kind of play around with it, get your shoulders back on your back, powerfully squeezing. So as I use the ankles as leverage and squeeze the legs straighter, they're gonna squeeze my arm, and that gives you even more stability to the whole thing. Cool? So, of course, always try it on both sides, balance it out. We'll do a quick one on the other side. Again, thread that hand through, set up your foundation, shoulder distance. This, remember, this other arm is floating free. Then I'm gonna hike, swing my thigh up as high as I can on my arm, bend the elbows, heart towards the ground, feel that floating point, and then squeeze the legs out straight as you can onto the side if you want. Play with that. You can even do like push-ups if you really want to play and impress someone. I don't know. So I hope you enjoyed that. Check out all my other videos, and if you have any questions, please let me know in the comments below. If you want me to do anything posture that you thought might be fun to learn or play with, give me a shout. And I'll see you again soon. Namaste.